Okay, suppose you are in the interview and let's say you are discussing about different food safety standards or different food safety laws. Then in that case, there will be a very high chance that the interviewer may ask questions which is related to ISO, International Organization for Standardization, or questions which is related to HACCP. On ISO, I recently uploaded a video. If you haven't checked yet, make sure to check that video after watching this video. About HACCP, let's explore together in this video. So hello guys, my name is Shreyans. I'm a third year student of BTech Food Technology. And on this YouTube channel, you will get all information regarding food technology and its application. So if you end up liking this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button, press the bell icon for the future updates. Now let's get started. Alright, so what is HACCP? To understand what is HACCP, how it works, let's discuss the 7 principles of HACCP. By doing this, at the end, you will come to know what is HACCP and how it works. Okay, so the first principle of HACCP, Hazard Analysis Critical Control Point, is to conduct the hazard analysis. See, analyzing the hazard in the food industry is very necessary throughout the process of food processing, either at the time of selection of raw material or at the time of processing, manufacturing, marketing. Analyzing the hazard is very important. The HACCP team must define the criteria to identify each specific hazard. Remember, it will be different for different food products, and evaluate each hazard for its potential risk and how it impacts the quality of the food. So the hazard analysis include 2 activities. First, identification of the hazard. Second, evaluation of that hazard, which is identified. Now let's take an example of milk. The raw milk is received in the dairy plant by nearby villages. After taking the sample of the raw milk, the milk will be checked. It may be possible that the milk is contaminated by anything like physical, chemical, or biological hazard. And if it is not contaminated with anything, any hazard, then the milk will be accepted for further processing. Now, this directs us to the second principle, which is the identification of critical control point. HACCP, hazard analysis is done, and now CCP, critical control point. See, after analyzing the hazard, it may be biological, which includes microorganism, it may be chemical, which includes different pesticides, there may be physical factors. This is what we have to control, and in the case of milk, we have to pasteurize the milk also. I'm taking the same example, milk, which is again a control point. But here, what is critical? Here, critical is for what specific time, on what specific temperature we are pasteurizing the milk. In the case of milk, the standard temperature is 72 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds. So this is the CCP, critical control point, and the HACCP team have to establish these critical control points at each and every single steps where it is required. So this leads to the third principle of HACCP, that is, establish the critical control point. Third principle, in the case of milk, at the time of pasteurization, 72 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds is the critical limit. In the industry, this limit is set or not set. There should be a monitoring procedures, which is the fourth principle, that is, establish monitoring procedures for critical limits. The procedures that require to ensure that the critical control points are in fact controlled must be established and implemented. And during the time of monitoring, if someone found that the CCP is not followed properly, the time, the temperature which we have to use is not being followed, then they have to establish a corrective actions, which is the fifth principle of HACCP. That is, establish corrective action to be taken where it is required, where there is a deviation identified by monitoring of a critical control point, or we can say when the system failed to meet the critical limit. Now, this corrective action is taken or not taken. How we come to know that? How we will verify that? There should be a procedure, right? Which is the sixth principle. Establish procedures for verification. Verification confirms that all the defined requirements of the HACCP plan are being performed. Now, let's assume that I am the person who is verifying all these things, and I am simply verifying and not documenting anything. I am not saving these data. I am just visiting, verifying these things and saying, yeah, okay, everything is going fine. Now, in this case, if someone is coming to me and asking about the proof, okay, Shreyans, you verified these things and where is the proof of that? Then in that case, I'm not having the proof of that, which is totally wrong. It is very important to document all these things, which means establish documentation and record keeping, which is the seventh principle of HACCP. Record must be available to provide the proof. See, without record, there was no proof that the requirement was met. Right, there must be no assumptions. So these are the 7 principles of HSCCP. All are connected to one another, right? Okay, so let's quickly recall the 7 principles and observe how the 7 principles are interconnected to one another. I just want to recommend you that do not memorize each principle individually. Connect all these principles together like this. So first, what we have to do? We have to conduct hazard analysis, which is the first principle. Second, hazard analysis, critical control point. So identify the critical control points. After the identification of the critical control point, set critical limits at each critical control point. If it is not followed properly, then we have to establish corrective actions, which is the 5th principle. Establish corrective actions. After the establishment of the action, it is very necessary to verify. And how we are going to verify? So this is the 6th principle. Establish procedure for verification. And after all these, record keeping is important for the proof, which is the 7th principle. Establish documentation and record keeping. So these are the 7 principles of HACCP. So that's all for this video. Hope you understand these things. If you are confused, make sure to watch this video once more. Like this video to motivate me to bring these kind of video more and more. Thanks for watching. See you soon in my next video. Take care, guys.